Hi everyone, this is Kelly Beard of KarmicTools.com, and this is your weekly forecast for September 29th through October 5th. So the week kicks off on the 30th, which is Monday, and it is Venus squaring Pluto. This activation brings intensity, and it challenges you to grow out of comfort zone into new territory, where your relationships and finances are concerned specifically. It creates very intense emotional responses and experiences with others that tend to trigger insecurities or hidden fears in one or both of you. Stability is not part of the equation at the moment, so prepare for inevitable change. You've probably already felt it coming, the shift in your relationship or financial situation. Well, it's here now, so you can be proactive on your own behalf, or you can suffer the consequences of postponing the inevitable. You may have heard me say, pay now or pay double later. That applies to this transit too. The natural reaction may be to try to hold on to the job or the relationship, but try not to give in to that temptation. Pluto intensifies everything, and the more you resist the necessary purification and change that Pluto brings, the more painful it usually is. It is better to clarify your values and priorities and choose change rather than have it forced upon you. Either way, once the dust settles, you should be better off because things either change for the better or go away altogether, making room for something new and more in alignment with your values and priorities of now. So it's transformation of some sort, but you can co-create. And squares don't always have to be hard and challenging, but they often are. It is just a chance to evolve and build some strength, let's say. And then a couple days later, you know, this is part of the intensity of it, is that Pluto's standing still and is going direct on the 2nd, which falls on Wednesday. Pluto is in a long process, 2008 to 2024, traversing through Capricorn. So we are now well past the midpoint, which would have been around 2016, and deep into course correcting time on the other side. On a personal level, Pluto helps you dig up any destructive, unconscious patterns, strips you raw, and confronts you with who you are and how you will survive when nothing and no one else is available to help or support you. I like to think of Pluto as our buried treasures. And like diamonds, it requires a very special task to release from within and bring into the light. Often, because Pluto rules death, rebirth, and transformation, something is sacrificed for your own greater good. Although it is sometimes painful and can be debilitating to some, it doesn't have to be. But it almost always is A, necessary, and B, ultimately liberating. It's something we would call a liberating ordeal. Pluto is traveling through the Capricorn sector of your chart, digging deep and activating any other planets you may have in Capricorn and Cancer, Aries, and Libra by default. They're all part of the same family. And they get stirred up at winter, spring, summer, fall. So this is intensifying this as well. So it's good to look at this as an ongoing purification and transformation of this department in life, and subsequently those other three areas too. Pluto moves generations and great numbers of people along their evolutionary path. However, every year when it retrogrades, it turns that energy inward, giving us unique access to our own depths, where our soul self resides. When it goes forward, like today, it is a very gradual awakening process that develops from there. Transformation happens behind the scenes and often out of the prying eyes of others, as well as your own conscious mind. This is deep soul work that only you can do. What have you really purified and transformed this year, or what would you like to? The retrograde afforded a certain purification in the sense that you are now better able and supported to truly let go. Strip away the non-essential in order to reconnect with your original intent. Change is greatly supported at this time. So anything that you are really ready, truly willing, and finally able to change can be transformed forever. Capricorn gets everyone focused on choices and responsibilities, as well as the structure of your life that supports and protects you and the overall stability of whatever house it rules. So that's where we're looking for this transformational process that is pretty long term, over the course of 16 years. But again, it's permanent change and hopefully building some muscle that is useful for you going forward. So we had quite a busy week last week if you missed it, and I also posted two extra updates on YouTube and on my blog. There's audios and podcasts if you prefer to listen versus the video, that I have the seasonal overview and a follow-up where I talk about the last quarter of 2019 in preparation for 2020, along with Mercury retrograde through Scorpio and the Libra light and shadow list, because we're in Libra time right now, and it's not too late to join Cinnamon Rose's Sovereignty in Relationship, which is just perfect timing for the Libra season. And she has a six-week course she's developed that started last week on the 26th. If you're really working on relationships, this is an unbelievable course, and I am actually going to be one of her special guests in week 5, which falls October 24th. So it's not too late to jump in and join us if relationships are a focus for you right now. It might be right on time. So that's it for this week. As I mentioned last week, it usually does alternate like this. We had several activations last week, and this week only the one, and then the additional Pluto changing direction, which is actually important. But really good energy for processing and integrating all that's come up for you, and hopefully doing that personal inventory and assessing the year. So enjoy those additional overviews and energetic support for the season and for the last quarter of the year, because 2020 promises to be really amazing, and we want to be ready for that. There's a lot of little things that need to get out of the way so that you can be strong and available to make some new choices and to seize some opportunities that will be presented that are going to be just miraculous. So we want to be ready. All right, so have a great week, and thanks for listening.